in some important cases. And you say, well, does that mean, and I've been asked this question, does that mean that our commitment to diversity and inclusion is somehow weakened, or that we're just giving up on that, or that that's no longer important for us? What I can tell you is absolutely and categorically not. That does not mean our agreement to name the school has absolutely nothing to do with our commitment to diversity and inclusion, which are core values of who we are as a university. And I'll be very honest with you. I personally have significant disagreements with votes cast by Justice Scalia and with opinions expressed about Justice Scalia. And yet I'm perfectly comfortable and very supportive of agreeing to name the school after him. And I can give you very specific details. I do not agree, for example, and by the way, these are my own personal opinions. If we did a survey in this room, I'm sure that we will have an array of opinions. Some people would agree with me, some people wouldn't. But yet, I have issues, for example, with positions that Justice Scalia took on marriage equality. He made a point in his dissenting opinion this last year, saying that this is something to be left to the states, for example. I disagree. I think it's a constitutional right. I think my gay and lesbian colleagues have the same right to marry wherever the hell they choose, just as I did. And that when they do so, we ought to grant them the same rights that society grants me. That's my belief. He argued that that's something that should be legislated by states. There are many other things. He took some very notorious positions on affirmative action or the use of race in admissions. He said that a law school, for example, in the case of the Michigan Law School, that race or racial diversity has nothing to do with the ability of a student to perform as a lawyer. I take issue on that. I think that there is a compelling interest by law schools and any academic institution to have a diverse student body. Why? Because in the 21st century, you cannot be educated no matter what background you come from if you are in an environment that does not reflect the various points of view of society. So you would ask, how come if you believe those things, you agreed to name the law school after someone who did not agree with those points? It's because in my view, it has nothing to do with that. What we're celebrating, what we're not doing is endorsing anybody's ideas. What we're celebrating and honoring is 30 years of a man serving his country at the highest level that anybody can serve the country in the legal profession. This is someone who was appointed by the President of the United States to the highest court of the land, who was, by the way, confirmed by the Senate unanimously when he did, in that for 30 years he earned the respect of his peers for being an extraordinary legal mind and for producing some of the strongest arguments that forced everybody else in the court to